Last week, we recruited 4 iFixit employees and performed some highly scientific experiments to find out just how dirty our phones were. We also tested 4 of the most common ways to clean cell phones to find out just how effective they are. While we had some clear winners and losers,
is it weird that the clean looks dirtier than the dirty?
Whoa. We were left with some major questions, like, what was all that stuff living on our phones? To find out, we needed an expert.
My name is Jason Lorenz, and I'm a 4th-year microbiology student at Cal Poly San Luis Obispo. Today we're looking at some plates from phone screen swabs, and we're going to try and identify some of the bacteria that are present. We have a nice tan colony. That's more of a streptococcus or staphylococcus bacterial colony. Those are commonly present on your skin as more commensal bacteria that are used to living there, and our skin actually sometimes likes them there too. These yellow colonies that we see here, those are Pseudomonas likely, and those are opportunistic pathogens, which means they live on your skin and generally don't cause you any harm normally, except if you're already sick or can have some other underlying conditions, they might actually cause an infection later. And what other people don't know most of the time is that mold and yeast are also very prominent on everywhere on your skin, really, even in your mouth. So we can see these nice filamentous areas around here of the molds. These bacteria are generally very common among everyone. They very commonly live on your skin, everywhere, in your mouth, and among other places on your body. Generally, they don't cause any harm. Some species your body actually likes to keep around because it gets rid of other more nasty bacteria that could possibly do you harm. On this plate, there are a few colonies. So Austin did have some dirty hands and a dirty screen in this sample.
Based on all our samples, which cleaning method did our expert think did the best job?
Looking at all of your samples, it seems like Ryan had the biggest differences. You can see there's a large disparity of colony morphologies, which indicates different species. And then on his clean plate, there are very little actual bacterial counts, and also a few less species present.
That's a win for our phone soap UV cleaner, but how does a microbiologist clean his own phone, and does he have any tips for keeping ours clean?
It's really important to wash your hands, obviously, after you use the restroom and touch various surfaces, come in contact with other people. But when you're cleaning your phone, it is really important to actually spend a lot of time on the bottom and the back of your phone, because that's where your hand is mostly placed when you're using it. The top of the screen is very important, obviously, but most of your contact is going to be with the back of the phone. A lot of the Clorox wipes and other wipes that you see are mostly antimicrobial in the sense that they don't really kill viruses and some molds, which is why I always like to use glasses cleaner, because it contains isopropyl alcohol, which can do a lot of damage to molds, bacteria, and viruses alike.